AMD brought us to their suite at CES 2017 to show us a whole lot of incredibly cool things. So I've got two demos behind me, one of which is four Radeon Pro SSG graphics cards. So these are the ones with the like 1 terabyte of sort of SSD cache on them, which they've got running in RAID for 4 terabytes. They're working with a 200 gigabyte data set, and they are rendering a photorealistic 4K image in damn near real time. To put it in perspective, a top-end workstation working with that would be doing like 1 frame every 5 seconds. But I know most of you guys are not into photorealistic image rendering as much as you're into gaming, and that's where this demo comes in. This right here is Doom at 4K, ultra settings. I actually had to use some console commands in order to do it because they disabled escape, but they're like, yes, we are running ultra settings, and it turns out it is indeed true. TSAA times 8, 3840 by 2160, Vulkan Ultra. It is the real deal right here, running at rock solid over 60 FPS on an undisclosed name Vega GPU. So there's four real pillars for Vega. There's the new cache architecture, which allows games to start using gigabytes or even terabyte scale data sets. There's the new geometry pipeline, which allows for an incredible number of polygons. There's the new compute engine, which they're calling NCU for next compute unit, so that's pretty cool. But basically, 16-bit data types are becoming super important for HDR in particular, which is going to be one of the next big image quality improvements in gaming. And finally, there's a new pixel engine. So they're calling it the Draw Stream Binning Rasterizer. This cuts down on unnecessary memory fetches. So say, for example, in a game like Doom, normally, the way the game is designed, you would actually waste memory bandwidth drawing stuff that's behind the rocket launcher. That is not going to be the case with this new approach, and it won't require games to be rewritten either, which is pretty freaking cool. So they're not discussing price point. They're not discussing when it's shipping, other than sometime in the first half of 2017. But what they did let me do is they did let me hold one, which is pretty freaking amazing, and they have also allowed us to take the side panel off of the machine, giving us our first look at running, operating Ryzen and Vega hardware working together. Now, I want to make it very, very abundantly clear that the finished design will not have gaffer tape on it. That is there so that AMD doesn't have all the, you know, bathroom engineers sitting on the can with their calculators on their phones, figuring out things like power draw for a product that is potentially up to 6 months away because it's not done yet. As if the, 3-inch, E-pin extension on the back with a USB 3 port on it wasn't enough of an indication. On that subject, a USB 3 port on the inside of a graphics card, I think I'm going to have to bring in an expert to explain to me why exactly we need one of those and what AMD is doing over here. So here he is, the man himself, the dropper of GPUs. Here, I'm going to put that in your pocket for safekeeping. I'm not going to let you hold it. Tell me about this.
So Linus, this is the stuff that I'm most excited about on the GPU. There are billions of transistors on the chip that you just put in my pocket, but this thing is I'm super excited about. This is only on engineering cards, right? This is not, you're not going to see it on a product.
I'm okay? That looks so cool.
I think I'll make a special edition for you and for me. Like we'll make 2 cards, okay?
Awesome.
Of that thing. But what this does is it gives every engineer in the company ability to monitor all the signals, most importantly, all power and electrical signals coming out of this GPU, remotely with no overhead. Now, every engineer, including the guys who test games, the QA guys, everybody inside AMD that has a Vega can see what's going on at the detail level. That's kind of what excites me.
Is this in response to some of the criticism with Polaris's power sort of
We're definitely, want to get better at our power efficiency every generation. we're putting money where our mouth is.
This is right? The overkill solution.
It's not, I mean, I think this is really, really cool because our, especially software engineers, now they can see what impact they're having on power in their, you know, in their whatever machine that, you know, they put a Vega in. So that's kind of, you know, really cool kind of, you know, attachment. I didn't expect us to be talking about that, you know. I expected us to be talking about kind of, you know, all the four cool new architecture features and kind of.
And our battery died. That was awkward. But what's not awkward is this demo, which is pretty freaking impressive. So a huge thanks to Raja for telling us about the power monitoring. Huge thanks to AMD for allowing us to be down here at CES 2017. Huge thanks to you for watching. And don't forget to subscribe for more great videos from CES 2017.